Reefing fam, March here, Fragbox TV, another day, another video. Last night, we got in some new corals from Australia. So I know you guys like these sort of videos. I'm gonna walk through the tanks and show you what exactly we got in. All right, all right, all right, where do we start? So a lot of times when we get in new corals, we put them in this tank right here. This is sort of our mixed LPS colony bed over here, our first tank, what we call tank one or T1 here in the store. This is primarily SPS coral, so we're running some T5 lights alongside some Reef Bright, which are still my favorite way to grow in color hard corals. If you want to hear more about that, I can talk about it in another video. I'm quite old school when it, look at these, hold on, sidetrack, I feel it coming. Look at these fox faces, look how nice they are. Oh, I'm in love with these fish. Look at them, just doing what they were designed to do, which is eat algae. So this tank actually used to deal with quite a bit of hair algae, because these stupid yellow tangs here are the world's laziest yellow tangs. We give them the award for that. And so we were always struggling with algae. I threw in 7 fox faces. I've never seen a tank more pristine than this one here. It's just spotless. I mean, okay, the glass is dirty, but you can't find algae anywhere. We were dealing with a mixture of some brown, crappy, green hair algae mixed in with some bryopsis. The tank is sparkling. Anyways, that's my sidetrack for the day. What I was saying was, before I got sidetracked by the fish, is I'm old school. I've been doing this about 15 years. There weren't even LEDs available. When I started in the hobby, you had a few options. You had VHO, halide, halide T5 combos, even VHO mixed with halide. If you know what I'm talking about, then you know what I'm talking about. That's some old school lighting. You can't even find VHO anymore. Anyways, let's get to the point of today's video. This tank here is where we store our new incoming coral. So it's kind of a mix right now of our new shipment. You see some nice A-cans over here and hammers and flower pots and some of the older stuff. So I'm gonna walk through and show you what is going on. Where do we start? Where do we start? I'm gonna start in this corner over here. And I'm gonna leave the flow on. Usually I turn off the flow for the videos, but I guess on this one I'm just gonna leave it on so that you can kind of see the way the corals would normally move without me turning it off. Nice Cynarina lacra something something something. I'm trying to say the
Cynaria?
No, Cynarina. I've been saying it wrong the whole time. Cynarina. Yeah, I'm saying it right. Cynarina. That's how you say it. Anyways, very cool, ghost-looking appearance sort of coral. And lots of hammer coral. These are, well, Australia has some of the nicest hammer corals, period. They're just fantastic. This is a golden yellow kind of variety next to another one. We got more branching type on this order, which is my preference. I think they're called Euphilia divisa, if I am correct. And this is a really nice one right here. This is a hammer, but it's purple almost to the point where it's blue. So that's pretty unusual color variety. And these ones are really nice too. Let me show you over here. I'm always showing hammers and torches because they are probably one of the most popular types of corals that we sell, at least for us here at Fragbox. I'm not sure what it's like where you guys are watching from, and it's pretty cool because you always comment below where you're watching from. I know you guys are from all over the world, so I really like that we have that sort of reach, and I hope you're enjoying the videos. Look at this. So this is a really nice torch coral. Wrong. I don't know if I was able to trick you. It looks exactly like a torch coral, but it's not. It's an imposter. This is a long tentacle plate coral. And one of the reasons why this is one of my favorite corals is because it looks exactly like a torch. Like, if you don't know what you're looking for, he's a spy. He's hiding among the torches. I'll go ahead and show you what I mean. It's not a torch, it's a plate coral. So you can see here from the base, it's a little bit more evident from the bottom that it's not a torch coral. And why I like them is because you get the look of a torch without any of the sting or aggressiveness that comes associated with Euphilia coral. So there's one, and here are two other really nice examples of them. So really cool corals. The only downside, I guess, to this is you can't frag them the way you do torch corals, but I find them really easy to care for. Actually, I saw someone else, we do watch other videos of people posting on YouTube in the store. So we subscribe to a couple other channels, and that's where I get a lot of ideas, is from other reefers and channels. And in one, I saw someone mention that long tentacle plate corals are hard to care for. I'm gonna disagree with that. I think that they're easy to care for, and yeah, kind of an easy coral. Maybe that's just my experience. I've never really had any trouble with them. but you get that same look of torch coral like you do those ones without any of the sting. So I really, really like that coral. Let me show you what else we got in, what else I can talk to you about. I'm gonna continue to walk through here, and I'm just trying to figure out which corals are from this shipment and which ones are from the last one. I'm pretty sure this one just came in. It's kind of hard to remember because this flight landed at 2:30 in the morning. So I was here up all night unpacking them, getting in the tank. So a little bit sleep deprived. This is a yellowy red sort of Favia coral, pretty cool marble pattern. Very nice when Mother Nature does that and mixes coral colors together. Oh, pipe organ, another one of my favorite corals. Now, I consider this, what is it? Pipe organ, soft coral? No, Matt, what's pipe organ? Soft? Well, we were talking about
soft,
this, right?
Soft, yeah.
Soft coral, but it's weird because it actually has a skeleton sort of base. So usually when I think of soft coral, I think of something like this, like Nepthia or leather, where it's just completely soft with absolutely no skeleton structure to it. This on the bottom is just a piece of live rock that it's attached to. And so he attaches with his foot to this piece. Oh, that's actually a shell of a hermit. Crowned Mexican turbo snail, as you can see right here. But completely soft, no calcium structure whatsoever. I don't know why I took it out of the water. I'm petting it, I'm probably upsetting it, and my fingers smell bad now, so I'm gonna stick it back in. So pipe organ is a coral that's considered soft if you look it up or research into the coral, but it's weird because, okay, look, I'm gonna show you. This part is soft, so if I go ahead and touch the tentacles here, you see how he retracts. Oh, isn't that cool how he's retracting into his waist? Sorry, buddy, I'm pissing you off for the YouTubers, for the purpose of this video. Okay, so I'm pissing him off, and I'll show you the base of it now. This is called Tubipora musica. So, kind of sounds like pipe organ if you think of the Latin name. Tubipora, because they're like, look, they're like these tubes, and musica, pipe organ. That's where we get the name from. But it's got this calcium structure, and the polyps retract here into the body. So, it has to form this structure somehow. It has to calcify in order to grow. So, to me, that's not really a soft coral. So, that's just, I don't know, one of those things. That's kind of my second sidetrack of the day, I guess. Let me walk over to this side and show you some of the acans that we got in. These are acan lords, and they are just spectacular. So I think hands down, I'm just gonna say, oh, this is a micromusa. This is really cool. We call them volcano micros. And these got reclassified. These are acan lordowensis, but I believe last year, the Latin name got reclassified. Who decides Latin names of corals? I don't know. And if you'd know, maybe comment in the comments below, because I really have no idea. But I'm going to keep calling them acan lords, because that's what I called them for 15 years. And I like calling them acan lords. So I'm going to keep doing it, even though I guess now I am technically wrong. What I was saying was, hands down, Australia for acan lords, lordowensis, they have the nicest, in my opinion, the colors, the patterns. Look at this thing here. It looks photoshopped or fake. I see oranges, yellows, reds, stripes of green with a blue mouth. They're just incredible. And the nice thing about acans, I'm going to show you Dylan's tank, the Fusion 20, in a second. You can group them all together. These corals have virtually no sting, so they can touch side by side their skeleton, and they're not going to hurt anybody. So over here, and let me show you Dylan's tank, what he's done, because it's very cool. He's got the most fantastic acan garden going on. If you haven't already, hi, Mr. Clownfish. If you haven't seen this tank, this is Dylan's Fusion 20, Innovative Marine Fusion 20, that we have here running in the store. And we've done lots of other videos kind of walking through what he's running, the lights and filter and all the corals. But this is why I think acans are some of the most popular corals. They just look awesome in terms of color and puffiness. This is textbook for a happy acan. So you can see the ones that we brought in don't necessarily look like that yet. They've only been in the tanks for about a day. So they have this sort of kind of sunken in recessed look, but I can tell you that from personal experience that they're quite healthy. They're going to open up. It just take a little bit of time. So even if you get one from another hobbyist or receive one in the mail, it can take, you know, a week or a bit before you get them looking really nice and puffy like this. This is how we want acans to look, just like obese fat jumping out of their skeleton, golf ball size or toonie size heads. If you don't know what a toonie is, we're here in Canada. I know a lot of you guys are not in Canada, but that's what we call this little $2 coin, just for size and reference. But the acans came really, really nice. This Acanthophilia came on our last order, but also from Australia. No, I'm lying, Indonesia. Okay, what I really wanted to show you today was two things. This right here, wow, Bauer Banky. We don't get these corals in often, and I've never seen one with this pattern or color. Sorry about that distraction. This gentleman here is actually from British Columbia, which is on the opposite side of the country. So you happen to be in Toronto and came to visit the store. Just for a reference of how far away that is, let's say you live in, I don't know, what's on the East Coast? Florida, it'd be like someone visiting from California. So complete opposite side, 6-hour flight on the other side of the country. Had to stop the video to say hi. We love when you guys come to visit us. Anytime you're in the Toronto area, we're open 7 days a week. Come and check us out. What I was saying was this Bauer Banky is just wow. Wow, 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 wow. And we have a new section on our site called Fragbox Finest. So what that is, it's basically the nicest of the nicest, the corals that make you stop and say, holy shit, is that even real? So right now there's only three up there. If anything's gonna be in that category under Fragbox Finest is because it's really the creme de la creme, the absolute nicest, rarest, unusual pieces that you're gonna find. And it's not to say that other corals aren't amazing and colorful and worth purchasing, like you know, this Dragon Soul Torch, or oh, we got more Christmas worms here. They just went in, or maybe they'll come out. But the corals that are just like, wow, I've never seen that before and I've been doing this a long time, or you know, we never ever ever get something like that in, those pieces are going to end up in this section called Fragbox's Finest. So that Bauer Banky that I just showed you is going up there, and then it'll be accompanied by this crazy wall hammer. This thing, in terms of size and color, it's a glowing yellow, electric, vibrant, just amazing, amazing piece. It is quite large. If you really want it, I will ship it, but I prefer to sell something like this local. The larger a coral is, especially LPS, acro is actually like SPS as well too, they're tricky to ship, because what happens is you throw them in a bag and then they gunk up and they basically shit in the bag, and that they're sitting in that as they're traveling. And for small frags, and 99 out of 100 corals, that's not a problem. But when you get into the larger pieces like that one, it's a little bit trickier to ship and there's a little bit more risk involved. So we typically will try and sell stuff like that locally. It's just, I don't want to risk losing a piece like that, not only because it's rare and colorful and beautiful, but it's just a beautiful specimen and animal altogether. So this Bauer Banky definitely going as part of Fragbox's Finest. Very unusual coral. We don't get Bauer Bankies in often, and we don't get them in that color variety. Same with this over here. This is a really nice red one, and a couple more over here, or one or two more really cool varieties. The Elegance coral came in really nice, and they have very unique orange glowing tips to them. So if you're looking for a nice Elegance, those will go up on the site shortly. This is a pretty cool chalice coral, and if you notice, this video is going on a little bit longer than usual. So usually around 7-8 minutes I try and cap it, but I noticed in the comments that people have been asking us to do longer videos. So if that's something you want to see, give us a thumbs up on this one or comment below, and that'll let me know that you want me to talk more, because I love talking about this stuff. If you haven't noticed by the video a day, this is, I can talk all day 24/7 non-stop about corals. It's what I was designed to do. So if that's what you want me to do, I'll keep doing it. I'll talk more, I'll show you more, I'll get more in depth into the corals, and we can make longer, longer and longer videos until you say, March, that's enough, shut up, you know, cut it back a little bit. But whenever we get to that point, when we get to that point, that's when we'll cross that line. These are really nice. Candy Apple Blastomusa. So this is Blastomusa Welsi. And from Australia, we also get another variety called Blastomusa Merletti. Let me see, I think I have a small frag of one I can show you. It's kind of a more rare variety of Blasto. I see one over here. Dun, dun, dun. So these are like tiny heads of Blastos. They're about, what's a good size reference? I don't know, 1/2 inch across, maybe even less than that. They're quite small. And the other ones that I just showed you are called Blastomusa Welsi, like these ones over here. These are the Welsis. So they're close to like Acans in terms of appearance and size, even the way they grow and care. They're really, really, they would be like the cousins of the Acan Lords. They're quite easy to keep. These are really nice pipe organ. If you haven't already grabbed one, that's my sales plug for the day. We don't get them this nice, big and bright often. They're up on the site. I think they're called Ultra Pipe Organs, but those are really nice. I'm not usually trying to sell you stuff in the videos. I'm just trying to show you what we got in, because I really enjoy doing this. Let me show you what else. Some sun coral. These are cool. So we have yellow variety, this branching orange one over here, and another yellow one, and some chalice, and one big orange one back over on this side. Some very cool leathers as well. This over here, if you're just wondering, I keep passing over this basket. So what happens is naturally sometimes corals will just come off the plugs, and sometimes they'll just sprout babies like these mushrooms over here, some suspicularia, some Kenya tree, zinnia, GSP, clove polyps, more mushrooms. So sometimes we'll find corals that come off the plugs or just naturally grow, and they land in the bottom here. As you can see, kind of our detritus builds up in a few specific spots underneath the tank. So what we'll do is go and collect them. A lot of times they're soft coral, so they're loose, and we can't glue them back to plugs because they'll just release from the plug. They don't want to attach. They gunk up and release. So what we do is put them here in this basket for a couple days, sometimes a week, and then they'll attach to that little piece of substrate that we use, and then that we can glue onto a plug so that we can offer them again for sale. So if I'm counting, that's probably the third sidetrack of the day, and what I really wanted to show you was this nice orange sun coral. This is a nice size colony. Yeah, looks good, super healthy, just came in, will be up on the site momentarily. So usually what I do is I'll try and take photos of all the new stuff that we get in and then try and coincide it with a video in case you see something you like. Sometimes it's easier, I think, to just visualize and see it moving in the videos, at least that's what you guys tell me, than just a still photo. So what I try and do is coincide a shipment with all the new pieces, take photos, add them to the site, throw up a video, and then as you're watching this, you can kind of go and look at the site and reference the pieces that I'm talking about if someone else hasn't already grabbed them. Some pieces I can tell you sell very, very quickly, and if you've spent any time on our site, you know that nice pieces, they go fast in a matter of minutes. I don't know how you guys do it. I've been operating the site for 10 years and I'm convinced you sit there and press refresh, because sometimes I'll be on the computer uploading pieces and they're selling as I'm uploading them. So kudos to you coral magicians out there, however you figured it out. But nice stuff, don't hesitate. If you have something in your cart on the site, it's first come, first serve. Go ahead and just check out and buy it. This is a cool scoli, Australian scoli. We only got one. So usually from Australia, we do get quite a large number of scolis of different colors and patterns, but our supplier, for whatever reason, on this one just had the one. So we'll take what we can get. This cool red flower pot. Yeah, flower pot colony, which is also available on the site. And typically we're fragging these down into smaller pieces, but sometimes I try to offer them a little bit larger just for people that, you know, maybe you got a big tank and you don't want a little frag, or you don't feel like waiting for them to grow. Very nice zoanthids. Actually, these are from our last shipment. These were from Indonesia, but they're coloring up. They're looking really good. And I think I'm going to move them over to T5, because I can tell you, zoas can take some serious light, and under high T5 lighting, it really exaggerates and pulls out the color of the bacteria, the zooanthangsyl, or whatever you call it, that's actually giving them that color. These are some nice mushrooms, actually, that have come up from the basement that I've been growing. And unfortunately, they're here for not the best reason. This system over here, as I keep mentioning in every video, going through trouble. I'm confident that I figured out exactly what was wrong, and I'm going to do a very long sidetrack March style video explaining what happened, at least what I think happened, to this aquarium, and why I lost a few corals and was kind of going in a very negative direction. But that's all been figured out. So those mushrooms, in order to kind of save them, it's one of the nice things about having some separate systems. Let's say something in here isn't doing terribly well, we can pick it up and move it to here. And sometimes that change of water and chemistry is enough to save a coral if it looks like it's not doing well. Usually don't touch corals. You know, I recommend do less. If you see some of the other videos, kind of have a hands-off approach. But sometimes, for whatever reason, there's something in the water or just something bothering them. They're kind of complex organisms in that way. This is why this green digi is also here. It wasn't doing terribly well. And he's so big, I don't have a spot for him. So unfortunately, he's sticking out of the water and losing some of his tips. I think I covered just about everything, though, that came in. Oh, this is really nice, too. This is an electric green Favia coral. This thing is crazy. And it's got some nice black pattern sort of painted onto it. Mother Nature has taken her brush and just done some magic with this piece here. But I think that's about it. It was kind of a smaller shipment in relative to some of the other ones we get in. The next one we're gonna bring in is gonna be maricultured or aquacultured Acropora, SPS colonies. So this tank over here generally, hey Genesis, what's up? You're on YouTube, hey man. Genesis is a very good customer that's here all the time. And he drives a cool Genesis, isn't that cool? His name is Genesis, and he drives a wicked Genesis manual, you know, for the car lovers out there. We're car people here too. We're not just core people. This is our neighbor's awesome 81 vet. I would love to do a channel just about cars. Those are our two passions, so cars and corals. But this tank over here, damn, that was another sidetrack. This tank over here is normally packed. I mean, packed with acros, colonies, frags, and the like. So it's running quite low. And that's sort of when we decide to do a new order, when it's looking a little thin and looks like it could be beefed up a little bit. This one is definitely asking for a shipment. So that'll be our next one. And I'll do a nice long video on bringing them in and an unboxing video if you like and all that fun stuff. But I think that's about it for today's video of Fragbox TV. If you have not already subscribed, you know how to do it. The button's there. We're striving to do a video every day of the week. That's 7 days a week, 7 reef-related topics. And we always like suggestions if you have ideas for us to make content. I know a lot of you are probably really jealous of Genesis right now. This guy lives in Toronto and is able to come to the store all the time. I wish we had other locations and we could serve all of you. Sadly, we cannot ship to the USA. That is a question we get, I wanna say, no exaggeration, 20 times a day, maybe more. Minimum 20 times a day, 20 emails a day, 20 Facebook, Instagram messages if we can ship to you. Sadly, we cannot. I'll make a video explaining why, if you wanna know the real in-depth reason and answer why the corals that are here in Canada are unable to come to the US. And that's it. Thank you for watching this episode of this elongated, much longer than usual episode of Fragbox TV. Let me know if you want them this long. Let me know if you want me to keep talking. I'll do longer videos. I'll get more in depth into the corals instead of just glossing over stuff. Have a nice day.